Hello and welcome to PDFsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a BBA103 genius block. I have part number here IC660BBA103, and this is a thermocouple input analog block. And what we're going to do is test all the functions and features of this block. First, the handheld monitor, which is the IC660HHM501. We're going to make sure that the port works and that it can communicate and program the block. Second, the serial port, which is connected to the peripheral devices. I have it connected to a Genius bus controller. That part number is IC693BEM331. And that bus controller is in an IC693CHS397 5 slot rack. It's being powered by an IC693PWR330 high capacity power supply. And we're using a IC693CPU374 processor. And of course that's connected to, I'm using Prophecy Machine Edition. And all of my configurations in Prophecy Machine Edition are the same as what's in the Genius block. And what I'm trying to do there is, once I've configured everything in the Prophecy Machine Edition and put the CPU into run mode, and the Genius block has matching information, including block number, I should be able to get an I/O enabled light. And that tells me that the serial port, this is coming through serial 1, serial 2, and shield in and out, and going back and forth to the Genius bus controller, is communicating, and that this port is working good. All right, so the next things we want to check, of course, is the inputs, thermocouple 1 through 6. Now I have, as a test fixture, I have a thermocouple with positive and negative leads for the two different types of metals. It's a J-couple, and it creates a millivolt type signal, which can be read by the IC660BBA103. So I'm going to just show you how I configured this block, power up the handheld monitor, and I normally keep all the blocks and my test equipment at 153.6K standard. You may have a different application, which is fine. So I check that that matches what I've got. Okay. Now F3 configuration, F1 program block ID. And what I would normally do, I've already done F2, which is changes the block number to 1 and enter. And again, that's how I was able to get this light on, because this information matches that I've programmed into here through the handheld monitor, matches Prophecy Machine Edition. All right, and then I go back to home, F3 configuration, F2 configure block. And I have everything set to factory settings on the Genius block. You may have different settings, which is fine. But I do want to test every channel, so I have all these toggled for yes. And the thermocouple I'm using, as I mentioned before, is type J, TC type J thermocouple. And those are all selected properly. So other than that, you may have different settings that you need for your purpose, which is fine. All right, going to go back to home. And we want to analyze all six channels, F2, F1 to monitor block. And we can monitor two channels at a time, and then we have to move on. So I'm going to touch the leads to the thermocouple so that you can see the reading. And since all the channels are set to the same settings, all of my readings should be the same or very close to it. So the first one, and I'm going to mention the terminals that I'm touching in order to get these figures. We're going to go to thermocouple 1. That's TC1 plus and minus. And I have a reading of almost 35, touching terminals 13 and 14. And go to thermocouple number 2. A reading of almost 34, very close to the same. Now I'm going to switch over to 3 and 4, inputs 3 and 4. 3 and 4. I'm touching terminals numbers 21 and 22 to get channel 3. Again, very close to the same reading. Channel 4. Uh, 33.1, I'm touching terminals 23 and 24. I'm going to toggle one more time, F1, get to channels 5 and 6. Channel 5, I'm using terminals 29 and 30. And channel 6, I'm using terminals 31 and 32. So all my readings are pretty much the same, which is good to see. They're all within 1 degree. And that's good. If I held them on there long enough and tightly enough, I would likely get the exact same reading on every single channel, which is what you really want. Now, if you power up your Genius Block and you don't get any lights on, or if you are using the handheld monitor and you go to program the ID and you get a question mark and it's, you're unable to store or program any information that's able to be saved in the Genius Block and it's not responding, then that's something that we typically repair, that we see quite often. We offer repairs, exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same day shipping. So if that is something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.